Hi, this is Ardene. I wanted to make this video to show how to start crocheting. How do I hold the hook and what do I do with my hands? And that might be the hardest thing to adjust to when you start crocheting. It would be difficult to not have any instruction at all and tell you to just go ahead and start on one of the crochet videos that I made without even showing you how to hold the crochet hook. So most people that I know do hold the crochet hook with the right hand. And there's two different styles of holding it. We have a little flat area here for you to hold. And the way I hold mine is like a pencil, like I'm writing. Another way to hold it is like a knife. I know a lot of people that use the grip like a knife as well. But I'm going to show you what to do with your left hand. Now your left hand is probably the harder hand to learn. This you can kind of easily tell what I'm doing here, and a lot of it is in the movement of your wrist. Some people who hold it like a knife, more of the movement is wrapping the round yarn around with their left hand. But if you hold it like a pencil, you do a lot of twisting with your wrist to make the stitch. So with the left hand, I'm going to call the snapping fingers pinchers or working fingers, and I'm going to call the pointer the pointer. So that's easy. And then we have two leftover fingers. So we have two down here that I'm going to show you what you can do. I have a certain way of putting tension on the yarn, and most everybody uses one or both of these fingers to put tension on the yarn. And I'm going to show you a couple different ways. So when we're working on a project, I started a single crochet project here. We hold the work with the pinchers, with the snapping fingers. The yarn itself, the working end of the yarn, which means working end means the end that's coming from the ball of yarn. That one we put over the pointer finger. And this way, as we work, see the yarn is sliding over that? Don't worry about my left hand right now, or my right hand right now, what the hook's doing. Don't even look at that. I want you to look at what my left hand is doing. My left hand, my pinchers are holding the work, and my pointer finger is being used to make the yarn go around it. What you can't see in this shot is what my other two fingers are doing. So we have these two, we have the pointer, and then these two down here. Oops. So you can't see real easily, but my two fingers here, I lay against the yarn. And when I pull the yarn through, they're always kind of clamping down on the yarn to give it tension. Another way to do it I've seen is you wrap it around your pinky, then you go ahead and use the pointer finger to make the yarn go over, and then the pinchers to hold your work. And your pinchers should hold your work right under where you're crocheting. Again, don't watch my right hand, but look at my left hand. And I actually move my fingers with the work. All the while, there is some tension around the finger. And I have one special friend who wraps her tension fingers, both of them. Instead of just the pinky, she uses both fingers. So it's going over both fingers, and that's just giving it enough of a drag to keep an even tension on this part. And the more even tension that you have, the more even your stitches will look. If you have very little tension on there, they will be looking very big and loopy. So you're going to be tempted to want to help your working fingers or your pincher fingers with Mr. Pointer here. You're going to want to get that one involved, but try not to do that. Try to remember to keep it up, keep the pointer finger up, keep it pointing up. Okay. Don't even pay attention to or try to figure out what I'm doing with the stitch, just watch. Can you see the yarn coming through down here? It's sliding through with an even amount of tension. Okay, again, your pointer finger is going to want to be in the business of your working fingers or your pinchers, but remember, keep the pointer finger up and away. Even if it gets a little bit too close, it's still workable, but it's going to get in the way of your hook. So try and keep it away. And I do tension like this. Some people do tension like this. And some people do tension with two fingers. And that's how to hold your crochet hook and what to do with your hands.